Did you know that you can legally create a Stripe account for your business from any country in the world without any restrictions, even though you are not currently living in the list of the countries that are currently supported on the Stripe website? Hello guys, my name is Raymond, and in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how you can set up a Stripe account for your business, and I'm going to show you exactly all that you need to be able to do that by yourself. Now in this video, I'm going to be showing you three methods that you can be able to do this, and the third one is going to be the most important and the easiest way to do it. So make sure you do not skip around and make sure you look out for the third option, which I'm going to be showing you inside this video. Now we're going to go right away inside the video, but just before we dive into it, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying this type of content. Now the first method is going to be to use the Stripe Atlas option. And if you come over here to Stripe Atlas, you're going to see that you can incorporate your business for $500 and be able to set up a Stripe account even though you are not in the list of the countries that are supported. So the fee for this particular option is $500 with $100 renewal every year. So you're going to be paying $100 to renew your subscription or to renew your service every single year. So with this Stripe Atlas, you can incorporate your business and be able to set up Stripe. So with this option, it's going to take you some time, maybe a few months or a few weeks to be able to finish up this process. Now the second method would be for you to do it by yourself, and I'm going to show you all the websites that you can follow to be able to incorporate your business and then be able to set up a Stripe account for your business. Now what you just need to do is to come over here to this website called LegalZoom. So I'm going to drop a link in the description of the video. So once you come on LegalZoom, you're going to click on Start My Corporation. So once you click on Start My Corporation, you're going to enter all your details, you're going to enter your name, your ID, and everything else that you need to enter. Now before you can be able to set up your Stripe account with this method or incorporate your business, there are a couple of things that you should have handy. First of all, you need to have a valid ID. So it can be your international passport or it can be your driver's license. So those are the two documents that would usually work. And then you also need to have a US address. So you can get a US address from this website that is called Snap Mailbox. So if you just come over here, you're going to be able to purchase a US address. So depending on this particular state that you want to incorporate, so that is the address you're going to be purchasing here. So you have this bronze package, which is about $99 per year or around $10 per month. So once you have your address already, also you would need to have a US phone number, and you can get a US phone number through this website called Fanitel, or simply just search for it on your mobile phone, either on your app store, your iOS app store, or your Play store. So just search for Fanitel and you can be able to get a US phone number that you can use for your business registration. Now this would also cost you around $5 per month to maintain the number, okay? And then another thing you're going to be needing as well is to have a foreign bank account. So you can open a foreign bank account using wise.com. So this is the website here. You can come over to wise.com and then you're going to be able to open a bank account. So I usually recommend you come down here where you have Wise business account. So you can see Wise business here, and you're going to click on Wise business. And before you can be able to create your Wise business account, you would need to have your business incorporated. You would need to have an EIN, which is your employer identification number. So that will take you to LegalZoom. So they probably have options that provides you with EIN. So you can see Start My Corporation here. This would cost you around $149 plus the state filing fee. So depending on the state that you're going to be filing for, some states cost up to $100, some around $50 and all of that. So if you add everything together, that means it's going to cost you around $249 just for the state fee and the filing fee. And of course, They will also charge you for registered agent's fee, okay? So everything is going to almost getting around $400 plus or minus, all right? So if you also want the EIN, I think they also have a package here that gives you the EIN. Just follow the step by step on their website and then you could be able to incorporate your business and then get your EIN. So this can take you anywhere between 1 month to 5 weeks or thereabout. So, but remember I told you in the beginning of this video that I'm going to show you a way that is easier and faster, that you don't even need to stress yourself, just a done for you service, and then you will get everything within 2 weeks. All right. So once you have your phone number and your address, and then you've incorporated your business with LegalZoom here, okay, then you go ahead and then open a Wise Business account, and this one will cost you around $31 or thereabouts to open a Wise Business account. Okay, so if you're from Nigeria and probably you do not want to open a Wise Business account, there is another option that you can use. So you can go ahead and use this particular website to create a foreign bank account, a US account for yourself. So right now it is supported in Nigeria only. So other countries you might want to use Wise Business account for now. Okay, so I also did a video on this channel on how you can open a Cleva account. So I'm going to drop the link of that video in the description. So you're going to watch that video and I'm going to show you step by step on how you can create a Cleva bank account. So with this method, it's going to cost you anywhere around $500 to $600 or less to be able to finish all the process of setting your account by yourself. But like I said, you can use the simpler method, which I'm going to show you, and which is the fastest method and the easiest method. So all you need to do is to come over to this website here, www.regos.com, and once you come on this website, they are going to be able to, you know, incorporate your business for you, as well as get your EIN and, you know, get everything that you need to set up your account within 10 days at maximum. All right, so it's a done for you service. You just do not need to worry yourself about how to, you know, go ahead to do this thing. So actually, this is a service I offer, and my team members and I are going to make sure that we're going to deliver on this service in the least time possible. Okay, so you do not need to worry yourself about how to create a Stripe account. Of course, all the services I've shown you already, they're not going to be creating a Stripe account for you because there are some intricacies. I'm going to show you exactly how to go ahead and create a Stripe account in this video. That is once you are able to, you know, get your business incorporated and you've gotten your EIN and other stuff. So I'm going to show you step by step how you can now set up the Stripe account. Of course, that is what this video is all about. So on this website, as you can see, there are lots of testimonials here, and we've actually been doing this for the longest time, I think around 5 years now, and we've been serving Nigerians and other countries that are not supported on the Stripe website at the moment. So if you're in the developing countries, or if you're looking for a way to get your business incorporated, just come over to www.regos.com and we're going to be able to, you know, offer you our top-notch service. You can see lots of testimonials here to show that we really know and understand what we're doing. So the pricing at the moment is $250. So usually we charge anywhere around $400 for this service, but if you're watching this video and if you're coming through the link I'm going to drop in the description, you're going to be getting this for just $250, and you're going to get everything that comes with the package. And for my dropshipping friends, I also have some bonuses for you, which I'll be giving you access to a course that is worth $2,000. And you also be getting my personal support in your online business. And if you need to incorporate or integrate your Stripe account into your website, I will also be there and my team to help you to make sure that everything works seamlessly. All right. So now let's go over to step by step on how you can now set up your Stripe account using the details you already have.
When you come on Stripe website here, stripe.com, so this is basically what you're going to be seeing, and then you might be looking for where to sign up. Okay, you might not see, so all you do, you just come here, sign in, and then it's going to open this page. So You scroll down, you are going to see don't have an account, sign up. So you click sign up here. Then here you're going to enter your email address, your full name, the way it appears on your ID. Either you're going to be using your international passport, your driver's license, okay? And then you select the country. Of course, we are creating a US-based Stripe account, so it's going to be US, all right? So simply enter your email here. All right, so when you click on create your account, they are going to send you an email to verify your email. So just log into your email address and find the link that was sent to you by Stripe and verify your email address.
Now, after you have confirmed your email address, so it's going to take you to this page where you are going to activate payment. So you're going to click activate payment. So we're going to start with the onboarding process. Now, first of all, it's asking you for your business location. Of course, it is in the United States. Type of business, we're going to select company. Business structure, we're going to select single member LLC. Then we click continue. Okay, so here is where you're going to now enter your business name. Okay, and like they said here, it must match the name that is appearing on your SS4 or your confirmation letter. Okay, so everything the way it is, that's the way you're going to put it. Okay, and then enter your EIN number. So I'm just going to do that now. All right, guys. So on this page, what you're going to be doing is to enter your business address, your EIN number, your industry, and your business website, and then a little description of the services you provide or the product you provide. So it's pretty simple and straightforward. All right. So guys, this part where you have home address, you're going to see United States, but you have the option to change it to any other country. Let's say you're in Nigeria. So we're going to change that to Nigeria. Okay. It doesn't really matter. So you can now put the address, your city and your state. Okay. And also where you have phone number, you can change your phone number to your Nigerian phone number or your United States phone number if you have that, so it will still work fine. Okay, so I'm going to change that number. And then here you also have provide a government issued ID number instead. So you are requested to put your social security number. So if you're not a US citizen, so you're going to take this option definitely, right? So you provide that instead. You're going to select for Nigeria, okay, where you have NG, and then you're gonna put your NIN. Okay, so you're gonna put your NIN here. All right, so that's basically it. All right, so when you're done with that, the next thing is the fulfillment details. So they're gonna ask you on average how long after paying will your customers typically receive their goods or services. So for my case here, it is within one day. So it depends on what you're doing. So I would recommend within one day, right? Now here, you're going to add your statement description, kind of. So what do you want your customers to see when they buy your stuff? Okay. So you can put your business name if you want. And then you can put the shortened path here. Then your customer support phone number, you're going to put that here. Okay. And then customer support address, you're also going to put that. Now, the next part is for you to add your bank details. So you can select your bank if it is here, but if not, then what you're going to do is enter bank details manually. So the bank details you're going to be entering here are those bank details you got from TrueWise. So I finished entering my bank account details and then I'll click continue. Now the next part is the authentication of your account. So you're going to be using either an authenticator app, a security key, or SMS. So I usually go with this option, this SMS. So they're going to send a code to your phone to confirm your phone. All right, so you're going to use SMS. So I'm going to click confirm phone number. So a code has been sent to my phone, so I'm going to enter that code and then I'm going to confirm the code and continue. So after you've entered your number, they're going to give you your backup code, so you can just download that and maybe also take a picture of it, snap it, or write it down. So that's what they're going to be using, just in case you want to change your phone number or you lose your phone number, you want to have access to your account, you can use that backup code. Okay, you can use it to change your phone number, and you can use it to log into your details or into your account, should in case anything happens to your phone number or you don't have it available, so you can use that code. All right, so I'm gonna click done, and now we are done with this part. So the next thing is to go to the extras. Here you can select your product category. Okay, maybe you can just leave it as general service. Okay, so this part is climate contribution. So if you want to contribute to climate change and all of that, you can click continue with 1%, but if not, you can just say no thanks. And this is the part where you review all the information you have supplied. Okay, and when you're done with that, so you're gonna click agree and submit. So you can see we have automatic tax calculation here. So Stripe will calculate your tax automatically for you. All right, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna click agree and submit. All right guys, thank you for watching this video to this point. I really appreciate your time and I hope you got some value. If you got some value, please give this video a thumbs up. If you're not yet subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe, and until I come your way next time, keep winning. I will see you guys in my subsequent videos. Thank you for watching and bye bye.